So, the day has arrived. My Uni Pro pizza oven just arrived. Let's go ahead and open this up and see how this is packed. Now this just came out March 2018, so this is one of the very first Uni Pros out there. Let's see. Weighs a little heavy. Fragile. Handle with care. Box within a box. This is the multi-fuel pizza oven by Uni. It can do charcoal, wooden kindling, wood pellets, as well as natural propane, I should say. Now you need to get the propane adapter or the pellet adapter for those fuel types, but out of the box, it's going to do the wood pellet. So let me break this down again. Just packed in here. I should just be able to slide this right out. Let's put it on the side. Say hello to Uni Pro. Caution, your Uni Pro is very heavy. Please take care removing Uni Pro from the packaging. We'll do that. Side. So far, so good. I'm gonna slide this out of the box. This is actually upside down. So, I don't know if you can see that. You might want to orient it correctly before sliding it out. So we're going to do that. We're going to reorient this. We'll stop walking around under the box. That's it. Just kind of one piece there. Some scissors. A lid. This is bigger than the Uni 3, which is the reason why I held out for this one, because I thought I might be able to cook some larger dishes in here, use a cast iron skillet, maybe even sear and cook other things besides pizza. So, packaging has some tape holding each of these together. Definitely want scissors. There you go. And we have a door. Very nice. Making some progress here. Okay, everything is inside of this guy. Let's see what kind of goodies we have in here. I think this is the pizza door. There's the pizza door. Okay. Ooh. Looks like the Uni Pro comes with some hot gloves. It's a good thing it came in red. And it looks like it fits my large hands too. Very nice. Be getting some use out of those shortly. Okay, what else do we have in here? Is that an empty box? It sure is. Alright, maybe that was just a spacer. I think these might just be spacers. Yeah. Yeah, these are... Okay. We've got a lot of empty boxes in here that they use as spacers so that these things don't bang around in here. This is heavy. So this is probably the Uni Pro baking stones. Banking on that. Another spacer. More foam. This is probably the chimney. Bracket of some sort. We'll just keep that there. Okay. Here is the charcoal fuel tray. Nice. I think the pellet attachment is going to attach to the back of this. Turn this around so we can get a better view back here. It's actually not that heavy. It's probably about 50 pounds. I also got the pellet tray just in case. What I'm planning to do is try the different fuel types and see what results work best. So, I've also got the Uni Pro cover. I want to keep that protected. I always want to keep it indoors, but you know, if you're going to put it outside for a day or two, the cover is going to keep it nice. Keep the dust off it and protect it from the elements, but always store it indoors for longer periods of time. This is the pellet tray. Fuel guard. So the cover. You can tell it's really good quality steel. This isn't cheap. That's the pellet. And the tray. Yeah, this is pretty good quality stainless steel. Fairly thick. This isn't cheap. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to assemble this and then try to fire it up, do a couple of test runs. I have pizza dough ready to go. Now you can make your own pizza dough, but what I decided to do was save myself some time and I picked up some dough balls from the local pizzeria. Most pizzerias will sell you dough balls. Just, you know, walk in, ask them, hey, do you sell pizza dough balls? Most of the time they'll say yeah. All right, so let's give this a shot. Give us a couple minutes to set this up.